Several people have already remarked to me that the main feature of my story is that it has no plot. And I guess that's something that has evolved in my work pretty consistently, trying to get rid of those elements of artificiality, I guess, and find different ways of representing existence. And in this case, I use the biographies of visual artists, all sorts of different artists from different eras, as kind of ways of reflecting differently on contemporary experience and on themes like violence, femininity, self-expression. So I'm trying to use, I guess that's the plot, of these stories of other people's lives, these people who created images rather than words, to just look at life differently. So I called all of the artists G, and that seems to have had an effect I wasn't expecting, which is that readers try and work out who the various G's represent. And the reason for that was that I felt that a lot of readers, maybe most readers, have some relationship with visual art, and a collection of visual artists who they've found in life and who have offered them something, some reflection on their own experience, and that almost by saying G, it's like a blank space that people can put their own experience into. The G's are all distinguishable, and possibly elements of them are recognisable from, you know, well-known figures like Louise Bourgeois or George Bazalet. But in fact, they also represent a sort of movement, a progress, which begins with, you know, the pretty iconic standard figure of the male, entitled male artist who is a genius, but also relies on certain very fixed inequalities to sustain his talent, and requires others to be in a particular position in relation to him. And the question in the book really becomes kind of what is a female creator? If she isn't just a female version of a man, a woman who's managed somehow to survive in a world of male kind of moral, social, and aesthetic values, but basically to be playing a man's game, what is she? And I guess the book is trying to show how that figure sort of is being born, you know, in our recent history and in our time, out of some things that are pretty inalienable in female experience, out of the biological destiny of being female, the condition of being female, that actually that's where the creativity needs to come from. And it's sort of progressively that female creator becomes more stable, more real, and in the end becomes a figure who can thoroughly express what she has to say. So I think some readers may find the book hard to follow on the first reading. Maybe it means you have to read it again, that would be nice. But I actually think people want things to be hard. I think perhaps there are readers who are tired of a feeling of artificiality that increasingly characterizes narrative fiction. I guess artistically, my intention was to propose or to reflect what seems to me a growing fluidity in the way people perceive identity, the way they express identity, the way they view the self. And so the sort of form of the book and its fragmentary character is really actually trying to say something about that.